I always wanted to tap into different markets, basically. You know, the electronic world is a whole nother ball game compared to the hip hop world. So, you know, I've been messing around with the, you know, with the electronic music and just experimenting with it. You know what I mean? Cause that type of music, a lot of people were kind of like embarrassed to play, even though they liked it, but they were embarrassed to kind of play it because, you know, they were kind of afraid, or, you know, they thought people would just kind of like make fun of them for playing that kind of music. You know what I'm saying? So what I did was I took that music and mashed it with the hip hop. You know what I'm saying? Made it sound cool. Made it sound acceptable, people to like it or play it. You know what I mean? And then that's when that electronic dream came out. You know what I'm saying? It was basically a mashup of the hip hop with the electronic. And then from there, you know, I started basically doing a lot of the electronic stuff. I got hooked up with an agency, and from there, you know, I was, you know, going places, touring, you know, going overseas, doing shows, you know, for that large amount of people, you know, that are into that. It was something that, you know, it was new. I was still really learning, you know, and meeting the people that, you know, I was like taking the music from. It was definitely something new that I was experimenting with and experiencing, you know what I mean, at the time. You know, everyone liked it, everyone loved it. It was a dope, you know, concept. It was something that I was like, okay, you know, this is different, you know. We kind of like what you do with this. And then, you know, at that time, the industry kind of like completely changed, you know. Like right now, the industry's all about how many hits you got, how many views you get, you know, who you have backing you, who's this, you know what I'm saying? Before, it was none of that, you know what I mean? It was based on your talent, you know, what you bring to the table. So, you know, I got in at that time where, you know, they were still focusing on that, and I was able to bring something new, I mean, to the industry. And, you know, I'm still giving out more of that, and, you know, expanding and continuing to, you know, just do what I do. And, you know, this is gonna be the year where a lot of people are gonna see a lot more of that electronic side. You know what I'm saying? If I can, you know, talk to the young me right now, you know, I could definitely tell him, let him know that he definitely did the right thing. You know? He kept at it, stayed true to, you know, his craft, you know, didn't let no one bring him down. And, you know, just staying focused and not really caring about what no one thinks. You know, that's what basically made the A-Rab who I am today. Making that piece of studio equipment and a live instrument, you know, is what pretty much changed the game. It's what inspired a lot of people to get back on that MPC. Because there was a time where, you know, that wasn't really being used as much anymore. You know, that's when the Fruit Loops came out and kind of took over. And, you know, that technology, you know, where everyone's just like leaving the studio equipment alone and getting on that mouse and on that keyboard, doing the clicking thing, you know what I mean? I was always the hands-on type of person that, you know, I want to make the tracks out myself. I want to, you know, play around with the pads and, you know, actually play the patterns out myself, you know what I mean? So I was always that person that no matter how much new things came out, I always just stayed, you know, I always remained the same. I'm not saying my music and everything else stayed the same. It's just the way my working process stayed the same. You know what I'm saying? Whatever works for you, you know, there's no really need to switch it up because something else is, you know, came out, whatever. So just did the right thing, you know what I mean? He just kept it going, so it worked, you know, and it's still working now, as you can see. And the only advice and the only realistic advice, man, when it comes to being in this industry, man, is be yourself. It's cool to be inspired by a lot of people and a lot of, you know, different artists growing up, or, you know, whoever it is that inspires you, but don't replicate them to the point where you sound exactly like that person at all times. You know what I'm saying? It's like you became that person or something, you know what I mean? So, you know, when it comes to being inspired, it's cool to have that inspiration from that artist that makes you want to grind hard, or that makes you want to make dope songs, dope tracks. And it's cool to have a little bit of that person's style, but you got to make it your own at the same time, completely. Like, have people be like, okay, I kind of get where, you know, this came from, but, you know, when you're completely original, that's when you really get far, you know. And I was always original. I was always just in my own lane, my own style, just overall, just in my own, you know what I mean? So that's just, you know, advice that a lot of people just always, you know, want from somebody that comes from people like us, you know what I mean? It's just to remain humble, remain, you know, original, you know what I mean? So when you just all of that, you know, people will definitely accept you and they will like you, and you will definitely get far. Just be yourself. Don't go out there trying to sound like the next person, because there's already that person. You know what I mean?